Now, even more interesting is a brain hormone called oxytocin. Oxytocin produced by your hypothalamus and secreted by your pituitary gland. What does oxytocin do? Now, this is going to be fascinating because this is where we get into human bonding and connection and relationships. Oxytocin outside the brain causes the uterus to contract to start labor and help expel the baby during labor and delivery. So that's one of its roles outside the body and outside the brain. And outside the brain, it also causes the milk to be produced and released during breastfeeding. But in the brain, oxytocin in the brain causes neurologic changes that give us a sense of bonding to another person. And this is non-cognitive bonding. In other words, it's not a purposeful choice to be bonded and feel close to somebody. So if oxytocin is being secreted in a relationship that is enjoyable, pleasurable, and you're going to find in a moment it requires the combination with dopamine, if that happens, then you will feel bonded to somebody, a close kinship. And the more oxytocin, the stronger the bond, without even making a choice to do so. The oxytocin also calms the fear centers. So you become more calm, less fearful when you have oxytocin release. It lowers the blood pressure, lowers the heart rate, and lowers the stress hormone levels circulating. Oxytocin increases the sense of trust. So if oxytocin is being secreted and you're feeling that close bond, you're feeling a greater sense of trust in that person. And this, again, is not necessarily cognitive trust. It causes a selective amnesia. Selective amnesia, so that you remember the good things and you forget the painful and bad times. It actually airbrushes your memory. And one evidence for that is, why would a woman ever have a child again after going through labor? Okay? There was huge oxytocin releases that airbrushed the memory. Oh, it was painful. It wasn't that bad. Okay? It was worth it. You know? But that's one of the things it does. It also reduces pain sensitivity, so you can tolerate more pain when oxytocin is being secreted. It decreases tolerance to drugs, which means it diminishes the risks of addiction. And it decreases social aggression, improving social recognition, and more. Basically, it's like social lubricant. We get along with people better when we have more oxytocin, except in one place. And that is if someone threatens the object of your love. For instance, moms, you got this huge oxytocin surge at birth, and you've got this great bond to your infant, and you're down at the nursery, and you see somebody coming and stealing somebody else's baby. Well, you would do whatever you could, call the alarm, call the police, scream, holler. If somebody's trying to take your baby, does a vicious, violent woman come out? Okay? Yes, because that oxytocin bonded you, that it will cause you to be extremely aggressive if somebody threatens the one you're bonded to. So other than that, it actually reduces aggressiveness. Now, psychiatric disorders are linked to oxytocin. There is a variant of obsessive-compulsive disorder that in families without Tourette syndrome, you can have from too much oxytocin. Now, think oxytocin is the chemical that causes bonding. OCD is this, I'm overly sticky, can't let go of stuff. So too much oxytocin can cause a variant of OCD. Decreased oxytocin receptors in the amygdala, that's the fear center, is associated with anxiety disorders, both social anxiety and generalized anxiety. And then elevated oxytocin receptors, too many of these receptors in the amygdala, is associated with a syndrome called Williams syndrome. Now, Williams syndrome is interesting. It happens because on chromosome number 7, they're missing 25 genes. And for whatever reason, because those genes are missing, they get extra oxytocin receptors in the amygdala. And these kids, if they have this disorder, people with this disorder have no social fears or no social apprehensions at all. A child will walk into a strange room, and they will act to every person like they're their brother or sister or mom or dad. They just love everybody. They have no strangers. They have no apprehensions, warnings, or guards at all, because the amygdala is completely just turned off. There's no fear. There's no apprehension. That's Williams syndrome. It's very dangerous, as you can imagine, for young kids. You have to really watch them because they don't have any normal apprehensions. And there's another disorder that I'm about to pop on the screen, but see if anybody can guess what it is, which is an absolute reduction in oxytocin receptors and oxytocin production. What? And it's just the opposite of Williams syndrome. Autism. Autism is associated. This is kids that don't socially connect at all, and they're in their own world, and it's associated with oxytocin impairments in the brain. So, activities now which increase oxytocin. Think of all these things it's doing to us. Wow, this could be a very powerful thing on us. What increases oxytocin in our brain? First thing is childbirth. And this is just a graph showing normal, here's your oxytocin levels, and then here comes delivery. Shoom, this huge, giant oxytocin surge. There's 30 minutes after delivery, and then 3 hours postpartum, you've got this opportunity, this window, where they put your child in your arms. You have this really powerful bonding that occurs right immediately postpartum. And then activities which increase it, not only childbirth, but breastfeeding. So every time a woman breastfeeds her child, there's more oxytocin surges which enhance that bonding. This is one of the reasons moms often have a closer bond with their kids than dads. Dads didn't get these big oxytocin surges. See, it's not that we're really not so sweet and loving. All right, skin-to-skin touching. But this is pleasurable skin-to-skin touching. People down in Abu Ghraib or some prison that are getting tortured for information with the fists hit in the face, that skin-to-skin touching is not going to get a lot of oxytocin releasing. It has to be skin-to-skin touching that is enjoyable or pleasurable that you're voluntarily participating in, not something that is frightening you and terrifying you. Massage, for instance, can cause cause oxytocin release. Hugs causes it. Sexual foreplay, intercourse, and orgasm increase oxytocin release. Relational activities that are non-stressful, nurturing, and pleasurable all cause oxytocin release. That's how friendships bond over time. As we spend time together, we enjoy each other, we feel good with each other, we get oxytocin, we have this bonding and kinship and friendship. But interestingly enough, relationships which involve trust. Not only does oxytocin increase trust, when you extend trust to somebody, it results in oxytocin increases. Now, I put on here combat and mission trips. If anybody knows anything about combat, you'll know that some of the closest human bonds forged happened in combat. People coming back from combat will have closer relationships oftentimes than with family members. And the reason for that has to do with the trust issue. You see, in combat, people will find themselves where their absolute life is on the line, and they are out there with somebody that they completely trust with their life. That requires huge oxytocin surges. And when that happens, there's this forge, this bond that happens. Why is that important for you to understand? Because you want to be careful on what trips you send your kids on. This is why a lot of times, see, kids go on a mission trip. They're in a foreign land. No one speaks the language. The culture's all different. They have heightened sense of anxiety, apprehension, and there is, you know, somebody in their class that speaks the same language they can connect to, they feel safe with, they trust and extend trust to like they've never trusted before. They're going to get huge oxytocin surges, and they're going to come back in love. I love him. I didn't realize I loved him. Going on this trip, we have so much in common. It's oxytocin, okay? Oxytocin surges. So you have to be careful, this type of stuff. Trials and trust. Trials and trust. This goes back now to our spiritual. Understanding this oxytocin, understanding trusting someone with your life, with your circumstances, causes oxytocin shifts. Read this in the scriptures, 1 Peter. In this you greatly rejoice.